great scholar. He was a very deep thinker.
Yeah, but I feel like some of this stuff is somehow.
I agree. Some of it is. I don't rate Hume as a in some ways. Well, in some ways, you have to give him credit. He's a great philosopher, and I don't agree. I don't agree with everything he says. Like Hume, all I'm saying is, at least he was open-minded to investigate. When he got the evidence, he still wasn't going to believe. Because it wasn't the evidence, it was the principle that miracles don't happen anyway. But you've already conceded that there's a possibility. So if there's a possibility, here's the question, if you're open-minded, what criteria do you have to investigate the gospel to show whether the miracles happen or not? What's your criteria?
Investigate the
miracle of
the gospel. Why? Because I feel like the gospels are very
unreliable source. Now, I respect you so highly, but that is not the best idea.
No, I just feel like maybe it's not the best idea to investigate something that was written by questionable people. Like, it has been there to try a bit.
Okay.
Like, maybe it's not the best idea to kind of.
Okay, you made some points there. First of all, there were 5,000 ancient copies of the Gospels on the old ancient copies. They go back there, we have some within the first few hundred years. In those Gospels, time and time again, when it comments on historical information, you know the Gnostic Gospel? The Gnostic Gospel mentioned about Jesus, but they don't mention anything about history. When they read the four Gospels, they mention about Jerusalem, Pontius Pilate, and all sorts of people. And even statistics in archaeology found that if you look at the graves and the people who died in Jerusalem, the names like John, Peter, and all that, the exact how many it's mentioned in the Gospels to the size of the population was exact in the time of Jerusalem, showing you that the Gospel was definitely written at the time of not so long after Jesus. They are reliable, really.
I mean,
they are reliable historical.
It is amazing. I'm not going to dispute the fact that there is like historical evidence to support
something
that's
reliable.
But there's also
a little
bit
that
hard.
And I'll be there,
aren't they? Well, that's not fair. That's not fair because no historical information that we have. You see, this is the problem with atheism, right? It's not honestly, if you read Sam Harris, Dawkins, Hitchens, you read Richard Harris, all the atheists, I'm sorry to say, apart from Dr. Crosby and Sheffield, they're not strong on the historical Jesus stories. They're very, very weak, and they rehash scholarship over 100 years ago. But cutting edge research is being done now. Major works are being done. Yeah. You have to engage with that.
Yeah.
No, they don't believe
you. You have to engage with that. When you engage with that.
I feel like there are a lot of things in there that can prove that has happened. But I don't think that's also kind of like something that exists, something has happened. But it doesn't really kind of heavily prove any of the kind of.
The main point
well, Brendan, you have a lot of experience working with